Hi, I'm Lisa Dixon from DivorceTV and welcome to today. Today we're going to talk about how to help your kids get through divorce. In my new ebook, which you must grab a copy of, are 11 strategies on how to help your kids get through divorce. Welcome back to my channel, and if this is your first time, I'm Lisa Dixon and I'm your divorce expert. Don't forget to hit subscribe and hit the bell button so you get free divorce expert advice like child custody, child alimony, and financial settlements. Now let's get straight into it. Number one is all about putting your children first. Put them first. That means in every decision that you make, the courts want to see that you have considered what is in the best interest of the kids before your own interest or your ex's interest. Number two is all about parental alienation. Now, I know we've talked about this before. Parental alienation is where you do things or you say things which can intentionally or unintentionally cut off your ex. So it's really important that you're careful with what you say, what you do, and anything that you need to talk to about your ex, you do it maybe without the kids, you keep it in email, you keep a record of it, but parental alienation is about trying to keep the children out of it and trying not to have the children being caught in the middle, basically, and being felt torn between the two parties. So that's parental alienation. Number three is be careful what you say. Now, this is in front of anyone, so be careful of what you're talking about. It could be relatives, it could be friends, it could be at the school pickup, in front of the children, because all of that can get back to your ex and it could be used against you, and you may not want that. If you're still in the middle of your divorce proceedings, you may not want any of that to be used against you. So just be careful. Number four is all about being available. Be available for your kids. Now, I know this is easier said than done, but if you can try to just put down what you're doing, you may be working on something for your settlement, working on an email reply to your ex, and just 2 minutes of your time, eye contact, hug with your kids, whatever it may be, is try and focus on being a little bit more available for them. Number five is all about getting support. Now, there's lots and lots of avenues for you to get free support, paid support. There's schools, there's psychologists, psychiatrists. Sometimes there's court-appointed help that you can get. There's counselors. Be aware that there are support networks out there and there are professionals out there, and usually not all of them have to be paid for. There are a lot of free services as well. You're not in this alone, so make sure that you have built up a support team for yourself. Number six is play with your kids. Now, I indeed have been found to not do enough of this. And now that my kids are a bit older, it's fantastic because we can play the most amazing card games. Some that I probably shouldn't mention, like blackjack. Oh, and there's the cat. But it's just amazing if you spend some time and allocate some time for card games, Monopoly, whatever it might be. Those are the little moments that during a divorce, and it's a really, really messy time, and we know that. During a divorce, those are the times that you are spending with your kids, and they recognize it and they know it, and it gives them a sense of feeling loved and supported and cared for. Number seven is all about listening to your kids as well. Taking the time out to listen to them. Hear what's happened at school. Hear what's going on in their lives. What's happening with friends. And again, just pausing, stopping and taking the time, even if it's only 5 minutes, to just spend that amount of time with them, to open up and be available and listen to them. Number eight is talk about the process. Now, this is one of the things that I really could have done a lot more with, is actually share with them what you feel at their age that they can accept. One of the things my children said to me afterwards was they said, "Mum, we just wish you'd have told us you were going into court, or you'd been to court that day, or you'd had a big meeting with Dad." And then they could hug me, they could support me, we could talk about it. It didn't have to be all the juicy details. I'm not saying that. But sharing with them, talking with them is really, really important. They want to make sure they're part of it, and they are part of it, but without obviously dragging them into the detail. Number 9 is minimize conflict. Try not to have too much conflict in front of the children. These tips are all about helping your kids get through divorce. If you need to say something and your ex is picking up the kids in the car, rather than yelling at them through the car window or whatever it might be, maybe do it on email. Maybe leave a message. Of course, you know some of my other videos, and if you haven't listened to them about divorce journaling, make sure you go back and listen to that, because it's really important that you do keep evidence, that you do keep a documented book on what is happening and what's been said and when. Number 10 is tell them that it's not their fault. They need to know that at the end of the day, it's not their fault. They didn't cause any of this, and that everything is going to be okay in the end. Number 11 is tell your children that you love them. Make sure they know, even if it's a quick love you, as they're running out the door, as you're dropping them off to school, make sure you reassure them with those 3 little words that you love them. I really hope that these 11 strategies have helped you, and make sure that you download your free ebook. It's just for you. Have a look, download it from our website or from our Instagram. And thank you so much for today. Thank you for liking, sharing. Thank you for listening, and make sure you listen to the other videos, and we'll see you soon. I'm Lisa Dixon from Divorce TV. Bye.